All right, and while we're doing the little surprise here, we do have a special announcement. We do got a Bolt, the Super Pony, who is one of the heads of Everfree Northwest, that's going to be joining us for the episode commentary.
Hello.
Hello, and also we have a big thanks to him as well. He is the one that helped set up this interview for today. So, yeah, a big shout out to him right now because he's here right now.
Thank you. Yeah, that's no problem. Glad I was able to make it happen. Glad we're able to get something together.
Oh yeah, definitely. Really
cool. Unfortunately, on the side there, hey there, Bolt, how you doing? On the side there, I'm Brony. They go ahead and bow. One, I haven't seen the episode yet, and I have not caught up with a lot of the episodes, unfortunately. So I'm gonna have to be bowing out right now.
Yeah, unfortunately, okay. We're gonna lose both of our co-hosts here. One of them is about ready to die of sleep, and the other one is way behind. And we don't want to spoil it, so we'll have Deal, Bolt, Suki, and myself here to commentate. Which
I'm trying to get this tape off for you.
I'm just erasing some windows right now because I realized how many I have open. This will be the to put it in contrast, someone who hasn't seen the episode to me, this will be the sixth time I've seen it.
This is number three for me.
This will make three.
Oh wow, yeah, I saw like
because I streamed it twice Saturday.
Nice. Oh wow. Yeah, I saw it first time on the stream Saturday morning, and then I saw a rerun of it, and then I went to a friend's house and watched it twice, and I saw it on BerryTube that night. It was and every single time I was like noticing things that I never noticed before.
I really gotta watch BerryTube again. That used to be so much fun for me. I haven't done that in months.
It's still fun for me.
I
love it.
I need to watch Wee Bear Bears.
We got
that definitely. Well, in any case, unfortunately, I've only watched it once, so my reactions are not going to be exactly unsolicited, but I haven't watched it several times either, so a little bit column A, column B.
Vaguely, Jesus goddamn Christ!
Wow.
What? I'm about to get
you're
back
not
again.
Muted anymore, so...
I know!
Okay, then!
I wanted him to hear me!
Okay, Vaguely is officially the packing king of annoyance, apparently.
Yeah, oh my god, so much tape!
I think his goal was to use an entire
so
roll.
So much!
He might have succeeded.
God damn.
Good thing I got a pocket knife.
Yeah, I will...
Alright, well, let's go ahead and start the episode, then. We are running a little bit late here,
this
so...
This is why I didn't want you to open it. I tried to get it open.
You could have just handed it to me, man.
I wanted to open it for you.
Anyways. I'm gonna die.
There you go.
Okay,
open.
So yeah, Blank is going. Bye, so wait, before you go, Blank, shout out.
That's what I was gonna do.
Yeah.
Or is there still more?
Thanks for coming out. Hope you guys enjoyed the interview and such. Bolt, thank you for coming on, and thank you, friends, too. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Thank you very much for all your birthday wishes and such that you gave me. And hope you guys have a wonderful week and wish me luck at work as well. You guys take care out there, okay?
Yeah, happy birthday.
Yeah. Thank you, man. Thanks for that birthday.
Ow.
All right, you guys take care now. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Alright, and of course, I'm sure Comet here will get his final shout-outs in.
That was much easier.
There, okay. Do you want to give a final shout-out here real fast? While
Military Bronies and Suki. There you go.
Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and get started with the new episode.
I'll give a shout-out to our interviewers.
Alright, shout-out to the interviewers as well. And now to begin ye olde episode. Are you guys ready?
I am pulling it up right now as soon as...
And also a big thank you to Vaguely out there. He actually sent me several of the My Little Pony semi-blind bag comic cover things for the second series of comics. The little mini comic things. Thank you, Brian.
Do they come in the comics or what?
Well,
I'm
kind of.
They
have a little mini comic in there as well as a poster of some of the covers and a few knickknacks and things like that, which are pretty awesome, actually. They are really cool.
Huh.
The only problem is they tend to go really fast once they actually come out on market, so it's a pain in the butt to find them. And those noises is Comet squeezing a bunch of bubble wrap.
Yes, I'm being an annoyance before I go.
Something to remember you by, I guess.
There you go. All right, well, let's go ahead and get started then. I think we've delayed enough. And new episode.
You DM12, you spelled there wrong.
I'd give a speech to a class.
Wait,
DM12?
It's
T-H. That's
T-8. Hold on. I'm using Circuit. By the way, this is Comet typing.
Not exactly something you want to hear out of nowhere.
Up to the task.
because I think you go. All of you are, and that the future of right. the magic is in good
hands. Jared, I gotta send you something from the Nerdist.
Unfortunately, he can no longer hear you, and he's away from the computer now. Than the
first yeah. I gotta send him CM Punk's grammar slam.
Go for it.
I don't know, Spike. No I'd like to be able to get through the whole
Suki.
Speech.
I can't hear you.
Cars.
Check your Skype.
Come on, Twilight. You can't be
nervous. Oh, no, once I find it, I'll, I guess I'll send it to him.
When he decides to. You can do it tomorrow.
But I do have to set a good example.
Tomorrow, good night,
especially
man.
For magic students. That's why this speech has to be...
perfect.
I didn't do anything yet.
Exactly.
Jeez.
The speech has to be
Let's
perfect, so I will
time.
Make my dragon suffer.
When Princess Celestia asked me today, I was
yeah, tell him I said I would possibly send it to him, and that it was, and that you're the one that did all
okay,
that.
Okay, possibly send it. He may possibly send it.
In my fact, you know what? Now you need to think about it. Yeah. Copy.
A beautiful heart, faithful and strong, sharing kindness.
It's an easy feat, and magic makes it all complete. You have mine.
He's looking forward to it if you can.
What's he doing?
I have no idea.
Huh.
I have no idea anymore. We're just gonna go
there.
With this.
Okay, sorry. It's just that he reminded me of a thing that's on, that the Nerdist did with former WWE wrestler CM Punk. He did a whole thing where basically he took tweets that had bad grammar in them and he just ripped people apart on.
Oh, that's funny.
That's great.
Even if tweets are angry at you, then you rip
like,
them apart.
Yeah, like there's one that said where he said I think.
I like okay. the Moon Dancer cameo there.
I can speak from my own experience.
Then of course there's some where he's obviously just taking it too far,
real.
But it's still for,
and
still
in
for
the
humor.
Of my friends and I,
huh.
it can be traced to
and,
a single
there's like
event.
Like one says like dear at CM Punk, you are literally a piece of shit. He goes, no, I am not literally a piece of shit. I am figuratively a piece of shit.
Alright, let's...
I might never have decided to leave hers.
And yeah. here we got the, okay, and here's something that actually changed all of our lives.
By the way, I do like that. I do like that we
Without
got Moon Dancer, and I still can't remember the other one's name.
Celestia wouldn't have taken me
the other one's
pupil,
name? You have to be a little more specific than that one. Can you describe it?
And the most the yellow one that was with the friends.
That I found is the connection I share with them.
I'm blinking on the name.
It's the one that got her head stuck in the beaker.
Yeah. Oh, that was hilarious.
Yeah.
Can't remember the name for the life of me.
I will say if you haven't seen the Moon Dancer episode, it kind of goes with this one. Who it
seems to have well, yeah, you almost have to see the Moon Dancer one just to catch the real the little cameo there.
Starlight
yeah.
Himmer.
I'm just talking about.
I'm sure I saw her, Spike.
Okay,
but
well,
when
that's
I looked
spoilers,
again,
balls, but anyway.
I'm just wondering what she could be up to.
You know what I'm talking about if you've seen this episode and that episode.
Last time
yeah.
I saw her.
Forcing every pony in her village to have the same
her, yeah.
cutie mark wasn't right.
We're talking about a villain we met in the first part of the
now
season.
She's coming back for revenge.
Recap.
Or she was
yeah,
just
by the way,
really interested in
I will
beach.
Say, that whole
Honestly, Spike,
issue, the whole thing with the packaging
sure
reminded me of
saw.
Christmas a couple years ago.
But
a friend of mine gave another
friends,
friend a box.
Right.
He sat there with it. 5 minutes later, he had gone through 10 boxes.
Maybe I was just more stressed about that speech
than
I thought.
Several roll, several bindings
of
bubble wrap and several amounts of packing peanuts. All to unbox a potato.
Like
that,
it's
That's like
totally
the ultimate
true.
Trolling thing right there.
Welcome
That's great.
Home,
oh man.
Also, this entire episode, they just need to call it. Starlight Sass.
We'll go home, Twilight. Now
doing,
to
Starlight?
Screw you over. This is what you get for not locking your doors.
But I don't want to ruin the surprise.
Yeah. But really though, how creepy is that? I mean, can you imagine how if you were to come to your house
anymore.
And your enemy is sitting on your couch waiting for you? Like that's creepy.
See, the problem is that I spend way too much on a certain side of this fandom to where I know. Where I just see the fanfics. I see them happening.
No, I agree.
This is basically giving every fanfic a chance of existing.
Love the ticking noise that comes from the portal there.
What's that mysterious ticking noise?
I was thinking the same thing.
Snipe. Snipe.
Where'd you go?
Nice.
I don't know, Spike. Dumbledore. But I think
you
know, we better find out.
You want to know what's actually really funny? During the I was on break from the being in the call, I actually felt compelled to go watch some old Potter Puppet Pals.
Wait a minute. So Spike is literally responsible for causing all of this to happen again. And who says he's not a butt monkey?
No, actually, I would say he's kind of the hero here, because if it weren't for his touching that, I don't think they would have caught up with her.
Well, right. No, she actually says that the reason that she popped up with him is because of the scroll.
But if they hadn't used the scroll, they'd be screwed.
Yeah. Well, I mean, wouldn't she be kind of stuck in the annals of time?
I think she doesn't care.
I don't know, it's kind of like a Batman gambit.
Well, I think the idea is that when she uses it, she goes back. I think where she made her mistake was that she should have taken the scroll with her, is what it was. Because if she had, Twilight couldn't have used it, and thus Twilight would have been stuck being with a future alter.
It actually creates a time paradox where, like, that Twilight would not have experienced anything different, but the other universe Twilight would have.
The bearded could do something like that.
It's this Twilight in particular she has an issue with.
Do more than the greatest wizard in Equestria.
She did more than the greatest wizard in Equestria. Apparently very well.
With this. Star Swirl spell. Oh no. Come on,
so
let's go.
I think he's holding it upside down.
To watch the race.
Because the picture's on the bottom. And when Starlight had it, she was holding the picture on the top.
They're all illiterate. even Twilight.
Okay, actually, Suki pointed this out.
They've always just been guessing what's on the pages.
Yeah.
They use sense.
Actually, they just blast the magic at it and it works.
Oh, by the way, right there. Nice little thing. If go back to season one, when this happened, they actually fixed the mistake there.
Yeah.
Yep, a 5-year retcon right there.
Yeah, in season one, that filly standing on that cloud that kind of looks like Ruby Pinch, she didn't have wings.
Huh. Oh, and they fixed that. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, and what's funny, I went ahead, I actually came up with a way that you know, if you go back and watch that and realize the difference, that it actually makes sense in the show. And here's how I do that. In season one, Hunimar Chronicles, Rainbow Dash was remembering what happened. And as we all know, even with the best memories, sometimes little details get away from you.
Right.
Meanwhile, in this episode, this is literally what happened.
Or the other Pegasus was flapping their wings so fast you couldn't see them.
Interesting. Yeah, that's interesting. Oh wait, that was that one OC in the background there. Wildfire is her name.
Are you talking about Sipsy?
Yes, I think that was Sipsy's OC in the background.
I think you're right. I think the name was Wildfire. I can't remember now.
I don't know what Starlight's up to yet.
Love the oversaturation of colors here.
It's too late.
Interesting effect.
Twilight, I think. Already is.
Took me a few times before I realized that there wasn't something wrong with the monitor.
Yeah. By the way, I love how, no matter how much I tried not to, I kept getting sucked into having to reason how each of these universes happened.
But why?
Like, why specifically in this one, Sombra was the one that won?
What do you mean?
Or is it all the same universe, then just different places?
I don't think so. As far as I can tell, I'm assuming the map is pretty much going to stay in the same, like, literal location, as in, like, latitude and longitude of Equestria. It's going to be in the same place no matter what.
Okay.
Whole missing castle thing. Right.
That makes sense.
This is a question, though. You could probably make a whole fanfic on how in the world things spiraled out to cause that, just because Rainbow Dash got held in the middle of the air.
Oh yeah, this whole episode is fanfic fuel.
Yep. I thought the whole town was abandoned, though, so it's kind of interesting to see the whole factory thing and just ponies hiding in the house.
I'm getting a bad feeling about this, Twilight.
It's,
I know, Spike, but
wait,
this is
Pony. Wait, I never kind of got why they're hiding in their house, though.
Yeah. I'll be honest, when I saw this and the whole red tint throughout the whole thing, I seriously thought we were going to see Nightmare Star from the card game.
Honestly, I thought this was just going to be one possible future, and it took her like an entire episode and a half to find out how to get back to the past and fix it.
She's here, Spike.
Not just a constant back and forth.
I'm not sure. Now here's something I'm wondering. So I guess Carousel Boutique would exist even if Rarity didn't go into like fashion design.
It's their parents' house, I think.
No, I think she did go into fashion design, and then things went out of control with the Crystal Empire because she had Carousel Boutique back in season one. And she had that. Everything was there. It's just two seasons later, that's when Sombra first appeared. That's probably when everything went to hell.
Yeah.
So, essentially, this is almost like 2 years in the future. Two seasons in the future, kind of deal.
Interesting. Applejack is finally... What?
I don't know. How could I describe that?
Applejack?
So Applejack has finally accepted the Industrial Revolution.
What can I do for you?
Everything
it's
goes
so
with
good
it.
To see you. We couldn't find Pinky or Rarity or Fluttershy or
everybody's
Rainbow
gotta
Dash,
do their cause.
I just knew you'd still be
actually,
here.
What I wanna see is somebody doing Applejack but doing that whole arm woman thing with the wrench from the World War II.
Oh, Rosie the Riveter?
Yeah, that you one.
Silly Applejack, those are shipping names.
Nope. Honestly, the only name I recognize is Rarity, but she left for Manhattan years ago.
Probably become a world-famous fashion designer.
Oh, come on. There's no way Applejack wouldn't know who the hell Pinkie Pie
is. Last I heard,
well,
she went
mind
to help with the cause. Like
no, Pinkie Pie still lives on the farm.
The cause?
Yeah. Well, not only that, she probably Sombra never really got all party crazy.
What?
Where have you two been?
Actually, it's when. I know this is hard to believe, but you and I and those other ponies I mentioned are friends.
Spike's like, yeah, I said a clever line, and nobody paid attention to me.
I'm telling you the truth.
He told a dad joke, and he got just desserts. I would know.
Well, you will come with the elixir.
I've lived in these parts my whole life.
Wait,
so,
you're saying his joke was dad in the water?
Castle, it goes with it. But I still don't see what this has to do with
you
and I being
that
friends.
That was
so
good.
Starlight Glimmer used this map to travel through time and change things in the past. For some reason,
by the way,
here,
Gigabyte Sword
everything else is different.
Different how?
Actually, here's another thing I expected, I was thinking was going to happen. I thought Twilight was going to get all these past ponies together and just do some sort of crazy alternate present pony attack against Starlight Glimmer to beat her.
That'd be cool.
That would be awesome, wouldn't it?
Yeah, to get like the villains together or something.
Well, or just the alternate main six.
Or just Discord shows up and finger snaps the scroll away if she's stuck in there. She's like,
I gotta admit though, this I did not expect. Just a cyber army of mind controlled pony slaves.
Yes,
this is dark.
It's the darkest the series has ever gone.
Yeah,
by the
I
way,
don't think,
yeah, so
but yeah.
My opinion on these things, he turned them into predators.
Actually, awesome. Kind of a combination predator and just sci-fi Babylon 5 thing.
The show also implies that at some point Rainbow Dash had her wing ripped off in combat.
Well, implies, but not entirely sure. But the ear definitely gets hurt.
Yeah.
But yeah. Also, God, what was it? LSKM was like, how the fuck do you use a map to time travel? They're using a magical map to time travel.
Well, magical scroll and a map that it synchronizes all harmony, so...
You gotta treat it like a summoning scroll.
Love that hairstyle on Rainbow Dash. Love that.
I also like the short hair on Maud.
Yep.
Yep.
And even with Princess Celestia leading the charge, it still takes every last pony in Equestria doing their part, working day and night, to keep up the fight.
We go
to
war!
I just can't believe it! We stopped King Sombra! You and me and all of our friends!
But we aren't friends. At least not here.
Right.
Look, I hope all this helped, but I really need to get back to canning those apples.
Thank you. We're going to set things right.
I hope you do.
I hope you do. I'm not liking this.
How are we
the hairnet is horrible.
I don't know!
Yeah.
We're gonna fix this. I don't know.
What we know for sure is that Starlight stopped the rain boom.
And the map's still here.
Spike, that's it! The map is connected to the Tree of Harmony. It must sense that something isn't right. That's why it's still here. I'll just use Starlight's version of the spell and go back a little earlier and stop her before she even knows we're there.
And here's where we get the nuts and bolts of the spell.
Yeah, just shoot magic at it until it works.
Well, not just that part. No, that is a pretty awesome thing. Didn't work. Shoot magic.
All we have to do now is find Starlight and...
Found her.
Yeah.
Well, finding her will be easy, but stopping her is gonna be harder than you think.
She flows like with this magic, you, like one of the cake twins.
I created that spell to send myself back
like,
in time.
The physics.
So even when
how
you
do they work?
Cast it,
it's magic, and you're asking
here.
About physics.
It wasn't difficult to change Star Swirl's spell.
Yeah, it's like you can't.
That's, that was such a hard thing for me to wrap my head around though in high school. You do role play, and like the mechanics aren't fully explained as to why. Whatever universe is magic works, so you're like, magic, how do?
Oh, I get it. I made a mistake. It, she basically, whenever Twilight uses a spell, it automatically pulls into the same time and place, so there's nothing that, so Starlight knows exactly where she's coming from.
Right.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. It's more like a summoning scroll.
Of equality, where no pony's cutie mark allowed them to feel
sorry,
superior.
Sorry, I talked over you.
It was a special
that's all right.
place, and you
I just
and
made
your
a mistake on what was
go-
how it went with it. You took everything I loved.
You know what's funny? This entire gag was completely unnecessary, but it's so great that it was in it.
Yeah, yeah. This is some real. But this part right here is this is like some real Avengers stuff right here.
Sounds like a fair trade to me.
Cutie marks are cutie marks. You sent it to her death. You. Jeez.
Yeah, that's some Avengers right there. That's something right out of Avengers.
Jeez. I'm gonna take all your kitty marks away. No, you're just gonna make her plummet to death. Jeez.
I know. Twilight's like, I know I forgot something.
Oh right, he can't fly yet or ever. Maybe.
No problem. So when is Princess Spike getting his wings?
We know exactly what we have to do.
He is a dragon.
He is.
It's probably better he never does. Ugh. Could you imagine him flying? That's scary as. That's scary as all out.
Okay. Keep your eyes peeled.
It's funny how instead of like using magic to retrieve him, she goes all Superman style and scoops in.
Twilight. So well, funny thing is, Spike is more on the ball about everything going on than Twilight is this whole time.
He is, yeah. He's the one with all the good ideas.
He is legitimately the voice of reason
just
for the first time in three seasons.
Just remember how you'd feel if someone said those things to you.
Okay, I gotta admit, this is just
what's
devious.
Going on here?
Just doing, remember, mean it is to hurt people, but they're supposed to hurt each other.
Well, don't. What? I mean, you were?
Of course. In a world where every pony is unique, some
stop
are
being nice.
More special Twilight. Than others.
Fluttershy,
stop. To be cruel, is it?
It's like, give her the noogie. Come on, go.
Isn't it a shame we don't live in a world where every pony is equal?
Fluttershy, stop.
No one would ever tease me there. Wouldn't that be nice?
Recruit them while they're young.
No, it wouldn't.
Someone asked me why Fluttershy is so tall. And fun fact, girls usually go through their growth spurt earlier than boys.
Maybe
like
I can help you get through
10 to 12 for girls well, and like 13
sure
to 15 for guys.
Huh.
I know you only convince those bullies to not tease
adorable.
Fluttershy to stop the rain boom. Oh, that's not true. I convinced them not to be bullies because every pony should be equal. Stopping the rain boom is just a bonus.
Awesome. Starlight face number
Look.
One was blowing their eyes.
This isn't over yet.
If you say so.
And now we get into Stranger Danger territory.
See, and here's the funny thing.
Think you can stop for
even
a
if this had, sure. even if she had managed to do this right,
I hear you're
and had gotten
fast.
Dash to do it,
pretty fast, please.
It still wouldn't have fixed it.
The timing's
okay,
off.
So,
yep.
That and
you
I mean,
race?
You know. Fluttershy is not currently
fair.
Down with the animals.
You're a full-grown pony.
Yeah, it may have worked about five
wait,
out of six, but...
Alicorn? Come on, I thought you were fast.
Huh.
Yes. I do like that.
It's like the only time in this that they go back and somebody's like, wait a minute, aren't you an alicorn?
Okay, listen, you don't have to race me. I just need you to fly fast enough for a sonic rain boom.
I just need you to fly fast enough to make things work.
No pony can. It's not even a real thing. It's just an old mare's tail. But it's not. I know it's not. I've seen you do it in the future.
It's not creepy.
I've seen you do things in the future.
Gee, Twilight, what's the matter? Couldn't convince her to do the impossible? That's too bad.
Oh, poor Twilight. She thought you wanted to come inside Rainbow Dash.
I am so happy that Amazonas Queen Zecora is a thing.
Yeah. Well, that didn't gotta admit, the main, the giant main is pretty awesome, too.
If that's not a card in one of the next sets, I will be very disappointed.
Let's face it, all of these are going to be cards. We're probably just going to have like Time Twisting Tails or some card name, some set like that.
Sands of Time is already announced as a micro set.
Oh, boy, there we go then.
But I think it's going to be changed from what it originally was.
Yeah, I'm also wondering, okay, so while I understand that Fluttershy and Pinkie Pie are main characters, but how come the rest don't have like big tails going on right now?
For the giggles.
They have short
okay,
hair.
Well, that's it, guys. That's the end of the episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. We're gonna
see you in
season 6.
See you in season 6, people. We're gonna Rick and Morty this, and we're gonna have to wait a year.
Yeah. In the meantime, I hear a new season of Little's Pet Shop has just started.
Yeah, they even have an Applejack cameo in it.
Yeah, I heard that.
Actually, funny thing, isn't this supposed to be the last season of Little's Pet Shop?
Is it?
I don't know.
Yeah. I heard. What the?
Was it? No, I thought it was Pound Puppies.
Is that the one that saw that?
I was sure what? I saw her spot.
I saw head screen that said, oh no, an unexpected error had occurred.
Yeah, it might have for a second just because of the episode transition.
Yeah, Pound Puppies ended after season 3, and that was a few years ago.
You and your friends will never form your special cute.
I don't know. I heard from somewhere that apparently Little's Pet Shop was getting the axe.
I don't want to live in that awful future we saw.
I don't think you'll have to. All siblings of Queen Crystal.
By the way, is the Brony show on Canternet or Pony Chat?
Oh, wait. I just realized.
We're not on Canternet. We actually broadcast on our own, but we have a YouTube, and we are also featured on Ponyville, yes.
Okay, I was wondering where the chat was based.
Oh, yeah, the chat's our own IRC base.
Cool.
Yeah, so we can do whatever the heck we want with it.
Also, to Stacy Squid, because I realized you specifically. No, I was taught that. When I was talking about the other characters, I actually wasn't talking about the fact that the other three weren't there. I was actually talking about how Berry Punch didn't have like the pigtails too.
We're not changelings.
Nope.
Or Carrot Top, for that matter. I just noticed.
Okay. Well, there's a combination. Apparently, it looks like this year a Little Space Shop was confirmed for a fourth season, and then after the fourth season, it will be over.
Okay.
And apparently, the fourth season began about 3 days ago.
If they are changeling,
3 months ago, 3 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago.
I think they're not what they appear.
So yeah, after the season, it's over. But they just barely started it.
You have to listen.
Days, months, weeks, seconds, eons.
Beneath this sob, changeling hides, for it reveals the truth inside.
My rhyming is really good, you know. I should have phoned Dr. Seuss for the show.
Mantic, Lazacora, what's in this
the
stuff you don't want to know?
Worse I see, for it is we who should not be.
I think I can explain.
I'm
sure.
Powerful
so
stuff.
I wonder if it's them glowing here. Means something Chrysalis different because by their reaction, that means near. That never happened before.
Yeah.
Well, Zecora implies that the world they're in isn't the right one, just based off of that reaction.
Though I'll wager in your
that's what she was saying. She said that we're the ones that shouldn't be. And her
army tried which to is actually probably a comfort to her, because this one probably sucks.
Friends, as you know them, are not here, alas.
Yeah, and I like how Zecora basically confirms the Back to the Future style time travel we're doing.
Pony who traveled back in time to stop my friends and me from ever...
Oh, Zecora, she probably has dealt with even more crazier stuff.
...that keep Equestria free from strife.
I guess so. But this really is like the second time I've come back, and this world is even worse than the last one.
I'm hoping that they're going to start selling models in that. How could with that now. Be so different?
It would be that hard. You have like the.
Time is a river.
They've made dolls before that when you put hot water on them, they change colors in spots.
Yeah.
Wait, here's something hilarious. Every pony has mud on them, except for Zecora. Even Twilight does.
This part of the forest is dark and damp.
Zecora's got the green stuff on her.
Well, she's got the green stuff, but everybody else has mud.
She doesn't have any paint on her. Hers is all floats.
This is cozy.
Hers is all what?
Clothes. Zecora doesn't have any war paint.
Oh, huh. I never missed that.
By the way, Trixie far off in the background there.
The only chilling attack I see is the one that come here looking for me.
It's taken quite a while to find you, Zecora.
I just always wanted to talk with a country accent.
Not the hat.
Not the hat, the outfit.
What a lovely village you've chosen.
But unfortunately, the hat was sold separately.
Did we already point out the fact that this was the first time in the show that Chrysalis's name was actually mentioned?
And I'm pretty sure tons of Changeling fans were going, yee, there she is again.
Something you'll notice if you look at Zecora throughout the series and the comics and stuff is that sometimes her necklaces or her neck rings are transparent. You'll see the neckline sometimes.
Why would she ever trust you? Even if there's a chance Chrysalis will honor her word, shouldn't
you
try?
The little full changeling thing, that was creepy.
Yeah, right there in the back.
Stop Starlight and put the whole world back on track.
That's the line connecting them. That would be the joint.
Oh, the joint. Okay.
Like, yeah, that's where they snap together.
Huh.
Somebody get a can of Raid.
Yeah.
I've been saying that for ages.
Raid.
Yeah. At some point, Cadence just gives up and orders a bunch of off.
And now, big laser battle going on.
Not bad.
Oh, yeah,
but it's
going to
take a lot more than that. Lucky for you, there's more where that came from.
Yeah, I like how this showed something that somebody... I saw it somewhere online where, like, the reason Starlight's able to basically be on par with Twilight is she may not be that she is as strong as Twilight. It's just that apparently she's a better tactician.
Huh. That's a thought.
I love how dogfighting is confirmed within.
I mean, she created a spell that steals kitty marks. There's something there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See? Don't finish a race. The laser show is much more awesome.
Yeah. I love this thing. Just damn it. That's probably one of my favorite jokes while they're in the past. Just Rabadash like, aw, damn it.
Mine too.
That was so awesome. It's just the other
times we've come. D-Pad still hasn't seen this. But look.
Really?
Yeah.
No surprise.
Why would the map bring us back to a different time of day than when we
left? Ah, well, his loss.
I sent him a screen cap. He's like, what's this from? I'm like, oh.
Whoops. I love the Timberwolf animation here. That is cool.
It's the same
CG animation they used for the last time they showed up too.
It is. It kind of reminds me of Atlantis. Just how they did it.
Oh, it kind of does. It's amazing how that movie kind of just came and went.
Well, yeah. And had a sequel that was bad.
No, you don't mention the sequel. That was not a sequel. That was their pilot at trying to get a TV series and it flopped, but they didn't want to waste some money. Prove me wrong.
This place looks a lot cleaner than I remember.
No, seriously, prove me wrong. I'm scared that I might be right.
The castle isn't open for viewing today. The tapestries all need changing. Again.
Clarity! It's me!
I don't socialize with dragons. I don't know any pony who would. Rarity, you have to listen to me.
Dragons.
The future of Equestria is at stake.
I don't know how you know.
Okay,
name, but I
normally I would save this for next week, but I love Mythbusters too much not to mention it. Apparently, Adam Savage of Mythbusters actually just tweeted ponies.
No way.
No way. I'm not kidding.
Okay, I'm gonna look that up now. That's awesome.
Oh, I found out that I guess this, I guess this current tour with, like, the Mythbusters crew is the last one that's gonna have Jamie on it.
I'm actually surprised they are ending the Mythbusters series altogether after the season.
Yeah.
So I think it was, Jamie just was looking to retire. I think is what it was.
Maybe, or maybe they just felt like they've taken it as far as they can go with it.
Ran out of myths. You'll tell her what
she wants to know. Ah, well. No worries over it. It was awesome as long as it lasted. Possess a magic powerful
enough to change time. Holy in any case, crap, back, that is awesome.
Back on topic here.
I see the tweet. That is awesome.
Yeah.
Celestia, of course. My sister has been imprisoned in the moon for
okay,
years.
Okay, I gotta give it. That, so but that's it pretty no much what happened to Celestia. She got moon prisoned and... I do like the colorfulness of it.
Yeah, and it's funny. I didn't notice the multicoloring of the moon until the second time I looked at. I watched this. Choice, somehow I didn't see that.
I can take you to it, but you'll have to get past the Timberwolves.
I am the ruler of all.
We'll say this is the first time we've been in a time period in this show that hasn't dealt with thousands of years.
No, I know you can.
And if you are thinking of trying to escape. It would be very unfortunate for your friend.
Trust, I will not let you escape. I'm going to get as much screen time as possible.
Oh, it is multicolored. That's cool.
Yeah, I like that. That's a neat touch.
That's a nice little touch. Kind of depressing, but nice little touch. Travel back and change the
past. And now, poor Timberwolf. Nightmare Moon is such an asshole.
I will ensure that the elements of harmony are never found, and my reign lasts forever.
But it won't.
What?
In my world, my friends and I found the elements and used them to defeat.
Wait, if she says forever, then does that mean the Celestia and Luna really are eternal beings?
I mean, really, the show has not for its chosen not to explore how alicorns work.
Well, at least those particular alicorns. Now more than ever, I
know how important it is to step. Gotcha. You. Get wrecked, Starlight.
Now she's just doing dick moves.
Yeah.
Twilight's like, no.
Okay, that one was just weird though. It just has Tyrik blowing up the trees like he was doing at this season.
And that.
Yes, what did Twilight
say? And that.
Okay,
I love that face. That face.
Okay, that was kind of funny there.
I like this. I like Discord's world the best.
And Flim and Flam, officially worst of villains ever.
Yep. And all the environmentalists watching this are cringing right now.
No, you were right. I can't stop you. But you can't stop me from trying.
See, and this is, and I'll admit, this is kind of where the episode does gets a little. I don't know. It's more of the fact of how this whole thing ends.
It's the pacing. It needed more time. And everything we do here
in the past, even the smallest change, can snowball. Basically, that montage should have had, like, at the really should have had Starlight in those futures too.
I don't know. I think it's just the whole Back to the Future thing, where the people going to the past are kind of obscured from the timeline. Princess Twilight's is that important?
She's just being a jerk. How important other ponies' friendships are to the future. Like he said before.
I
can show you what the world is like without mine.
I don't think this ruined the episode by any means. It's just...
Hey, this is the one I'm trying to figure out. How in the world this happened?
No, I'm not saying it did, Deal. I'm just saying it would have worked. I'm just saying the whole, like, turnaround of Starlight Glimmer would have worked better.
You're in the wasteland, Starlight. There's nothing here. Welcome to Fallout.
I mean, what exactly happened to cause this?
I'm guessing Flim and Flam dug up all the trees, which, I don't know, started some sort of, spiral.
I don't know, that must have been one hell of a spiral to cause that to happen that quickly.
Or, I got it. It's the dragon, season one. The cloud of smoke.
Oh, that is a good one. Yeah.
Ship line. This might change your
mind. Maybe. I'm gonna go with the theory of Villmore.
Of what?
Villmore. All the villains start taking over, but then they end up competing with each other, so they just have an all-out war. And it basically destroys everything. And I had to take it away.
You wanna know what happened to me? So that'd be like all the villains occurring, like all the worlds occur at the same time. Then like all these storylines occur at the same time.
Essentially, like, you know, like nothing stops Nightmare Moon, nothing stops Discord, nothing stops.
Where are we?
Nothing stops Sombra.
That map of yours is connected to every part of
Equestria. Yeah, all of them going at it would definitely cause something crazy like that.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, and of course, Starlight Glimmer's entire backstory is, I lost my boyfriend to a cutie mark.
Sunburst and everything together. In fact, I don't remember us ever being apart.
I do completely agree with like a lot of people putting it out there that. I guess once again we're pretty much outside of spoiler territory by watching it
at this point, spoiler territory be damned.
Yeah, the fact that he like they don't just have a moment where he like just pops up at the end. Like there should have been that where like he like they had a they like they have a chance to reconnect at the end.
Happy horse noises.
That's probably a nice season thing, to be honest.
Just like that. My friend was
that would
gone.
Be. I never even thought about that. That'd be great.
Actually, wait. Where talent, was the? It was linked in one of my Skype groups. Was.
I never saw him again.
I lost my friend, so I'm gonna doom the world.
Let's see. Somebody found a really good comic for that.
Yeah, I've seen that one. It's pretty good. I was too afraid another
cutie mark would take them away too. That's ridiculous. A cutie mark can't take your friends away.
What the hell was that?
I'm pretty sure it's on Tumblr, but let me check. I probably have a cute.
Oh, you know what? I need to mark this video for later. Like to lose a friend because of it's that guy. Never mind. I'm going to stop the rainbow. You will. Let's see. Is this the one? Jerfy Girl Link? No. There'll be no way for you to change it. Oh,
jeez. It really is amazing how she's basically saw her entire future gets destroyed and she's still on this warpath. But I do know you can't
do this. Yeah, that's exactly why. Like, that's exactly what I was saying is that, you know, she sees the one future. Obviously, that doesn't change her mind. But then just the friendship speech afterwards does it. I feel like, you know, her seeing that, seeing a horrible future, but then having to go through a couple of them would have made the friendship speech turning her around make more sense. At least to me.
I
thought Sunburst and I were the same,
but we turned out different. And who knows? Maybe it's just a complex. She doesn't want to believe that something like this could happen just because somebody loses a key mark or loses her friend.
Because she's never had to go through that before.
Anyways, so deal. Yeah, I found it and there it is. That are important to Equestria. And screw it, I'll toss it out to the show chat too. Wait, let me make sure that click. How do I know the right one? Yes.
Where's the first place? Oh, you sent it to Skype first.
Yes. Okay. And now I'm sending it to the chat.
Why is her? So why is Starlight's horn glow? Oh, she's holding up the map, the script. So apparently Starlight can just stand on the clouds now.
She probably just casts a walking spell on herself.
Yeah.
And the table just said, screw this shit, we are not doing this anymore.
Yeah.
It's like, you know what, we're back to normal. Screw it, we're done.
You've used it too many times. One
castle. No, we are not letting you try this again. What in Equestria
was that? Is every pony okay? Can you do it again?
One group. Why do I feel like I just went through a cannery? Check.
Yes, it looks like we're home.
What's she doing here?
The backstroke.
Actually, it's kind of a long story.
Well, here you go, guys.
This is the Starlight Shimmer, or excuse me, Sunset Shimmer you'll never get.
I mean, yeah, Starlight Glimmer, or Sunset awesome, Shimmer.
But I never Twilight Sparkle. Sparkle.
Yeah.
On it, or on us. I think it's more than that. Friendship connects yeah. all of Equestria.
And ego inflated
and
once again.
One group of friends made its magic less powerful.
I can't believe y'all were able to travel through time like that.
That Starlight must be pretty magical.
She obviously has more talent for magic than almost any pony I've seen. My magic couldn't stop her. I had to convince her to stop on
She's
her
going,
own.
Starlight Once is going to become that, an eloquent princess in like two seasons but from now or in the 2017 movie. I'm calling it right now.
We can't just send her on her
own. Nah, I think she's just going to be the reason for lessons for the next season.
Something else in mind.
Hmm.
She's going to be the basically the lesson bearer.
Yep, she is the new Twilight.
Me
I
student.
No excuse
then
for
the
I
season
did.
6 premiere happens. So Twilight, where's Starlight at? She walked off a fair. Cliff and died.
We sent her back in time.
There was a terrible glue accident. Because even when one she ran into this guy named Christos.
I know something about an Ursa Major and a blue pony trying to take over the world. I'm
willing to teach she you accidentally put on the alicorn.
You have the power to make Equestria an even better.
She met up with her boyfriend. They decided to get married, and now they divorced. And she's going to make his life a living hell instead of mine. Easy.
All you have to do is make a friend, and you've got seven of them right here.
She wasn't looking at what she put into the cake. It turns out she did, in fact, have a peanut allergy.
She tried to put on those pigtails and somehow her brain exploded.
So what I want to know is, she had this like, you'd have to go back to that scene again, but in that little dream space just now, she had like this glittery stuff on her feet.
Huh.
I'm trying to figure out what that was.
It might
have been for effect.
Yeah.
We'll go with that. Okay, everybody's really seeing.
Yeah. By the way, you know what was really funny? During the premiere, somebody was like, I remember I was talking during one of the commercial breaks, and I said, and I was reading the chat, and somebody said there's no songs, this is worst episode, and I'm like, it's like, this is not supposed to be a musical episode. This is a plot episode. Shut up and enjoy the plot. By the way, if there's gonna be songs, it's gonna be at the end about something about making friends and stuff like that. And
yeah.
What the fuck happened?
I think every season's ended with a song so far.
I found some of her original concept art.
So cute. The face of Starlight eating the cupcake is so cute.
The bitch slapper.
Oh, god dang it. Really,
Gil? Wait, was Octavia looking at Vinyl a little lovey there for a second?
I didn't notice it. Watch this. Hi, Bulk. Hey, Bulk, how are you doing? Who are you looking at there? Huh?
Yeah, that's even creepier somehow.
Technically Applejack.
I think I traced his line of sight. And actually, if you really wanted to be, to like, directly link his eyes to a pony, he's actually looking at Scootaloo.
Oh, that's even creepier. Anyway, let's go ahead and move on. We got plenty of episodes that were submitted by the that we found throughout the week for the community, and well, we need to get to them because we're actually running a little bit longer on the show today. So starting off with Attack on Titan made in Source Filmmaker with ponies, because we can.
Typing buttons.
I'd say that's a good way to start that off, don't you think?
Yeah, I like that. That was pretty epic. I haven't seen the original Attack on Titan, so I couldn't really compare it to anything, but I liked it.
Yeah, I will admit, you know, that their attempt at making basically like pony Titan models, it didn't really work out that well.
I don't think they really had much to go with, but for what they had, it worked okay.
Yeah.
All right, now we got Friendship is Musical. Be afraid.
Let go. Are you crazy?
Wait, there's more to it. There's a lot more to this.
No.
See? I'd never leave my friends hanging.
Fuck you. Wow,
I didn't recall the ponies.
So later.
A baby.
Yeah. I warned you, people.
Oh, God. Oh,
who could not abandon her friends for her own heart's desire?
I have no idea either.
I didn't get that reference.
Voila! Where are you?
Look!
Where are you?
Ah, damn it!
Let go. Are you crazy?
Let go. Let go. Let go.
Sounds like that Portal song.
My little pony,
kind of does,
my little
that was
pony.
Yeah. I don't get that one.
That's a song that apparently sounds similar-ish to that. Okay, that one was just weird. Alright, now, perform this way. Now we got performed this way by the person that does the Paper Pony animations.
Oh, Yoshi Greenwater?
Yep.
Yeah, I love this guy. Definitely make more of those Prince musicals, though. Those are good.
This song may be familiar.
Yeah, I love the animation
totally
style, but this is one I did not expect.
Kind of like me.
Yeah.
Rara.
He probably could have I definitely liked what he did. He probably could have done a little bit more.
Yeah, well, considering how actiony the animation tends to be, I'm not too surprised.
The video in this playlist where she does the realistic piano thing?
No, I didn't have time to fit it in, sadly. No, it is an awesome one, though. Now on red carpets, well, I'm hard to miss. The press follows everywhere I go. I'll poke your eye out with a dress like this. Back up and enjoy the show. I'm sure my critics will say it's a grotesque display.
Yeah. Well, I went through the story on Saturday with my stream group. Are you guys familiar with the story behind this song's release, right?
Not really. No.
The fact that this song was almost not on the album Apocalypse.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because here's what it was. Weird Al literally needed only one more song to finish the album, and I guess he had the idea for this one. So he tried to reach out to Lady Gaga and get her permission to, or get their permission to, do this. Yes, that's what he does.
Right.
So he sends a message over there. They say they're not sure, or he gets told that they're not sure. Then eventually it goes kind of a back and forth. Eventually they say, all right, we want to hear the full completed song. So he does that. He sends it to them. They say no. Now he basically looks at it and goes, all right, well, I've already finished the song and I like it too much to just let it go to waste. So I'm going to release it for free.
Oh, nice.
It's going to be completely its own thing. It's not going to be on an album. I'm not going to make money off it. It's just going to be out there for free.
That's pretty cool.
And, well, the story is that
Lady Gaga has been found, has been made aware of this from fans, and found out about the song. And she pretty much went to the publicist that told him no and said, you told him what?
Huh.
Yeah, being
pretty much said that she had no problem with him doing it. In fact, she would have been fine with it from the beginning.
Yeah, basically somebody speaking for somebody else without having a clue.
It's almost like legal departments are stupid.
Yeah.
So see, that's the, and I will say, there's no real confirmation on that, but that's the that's the version of the story I choose to believe, because that in that version of the story, a publicist gets fired.
Ooh, I love it. All right, well, let's go on. Awesome. Here's actually something that I was really excited to show. Back in the early parts of the Brony show, there was a person that did different movies reenacted by ponies, and then they went quiet for a few years, so I figured that was the end of that. They just released Jurassic Park reenacted by ponies.
Is this the same person who did the DOTA animation? DOTA 2?
No, this is somebody else entirely, but they did like Harry Potter by ponies, Star Wars by ponies, Lord of the Rings by ponies.
Oh yeah, I remember. I saw that, yeah.
Poor Lyra.
Helicopter.
There was no reason to do that joke. There was absolutely none.
Except ponies.
Dr. Grant, this is incredible. This species of hay has been extinct since the Paleopony period.
Oh god dang. For some reason I was expecting a dinosaur head.
And so was I, but the pony head just makes it even the weirder.
Yeah, it does.
Dr. Grant.
Rainbow Dash looks cool with glasses.
Dear Dr. Sandal, welcome to Jurassic Park.
What a show's true form. Huh.
Welcome to Jurassic Park. You're all gonna die here.
They're moving in herds.
Picked off one by one. They do move in herds. Our science ponies are doing things no pony ain't never done before. We ain't spared no expense, I tell you what.
Don't you see the danger in what you're doing here? The kind of control you're attempting is not possible. If there's one thing the history of Equestria has taught us, it's that friendship and magic will not be contained. Friendship breaks free. It expands to new ponies and crashes through barriers. Courageously, maybe even optimistically, friendship finds a way.
Well, the question is, how can you know anything about an extinct
feline
awesome. Ecosystem?
So circuit,
and therefore, how could any pony control it? I don't want to jump to any conclusions, but look, us and prehistoric ponies, two species separated by 65 million years of generosity and kindness, just been
okay, so from
back
now on, we're
going to
be known
together.
As Circuit's Awesome Quarter.
How can any pony possibly have the slightest
we'll,
idea of what to expect?
We'll have new announcements posted in a couple of days.
I, for one, hail our new Circuit.
Where's the dino
circuit
pony?
Overlord.
He's our first interview guest now.
Holy sweet Celestia, a Triceratops pony. I'll meet you back at the main building.
I missed a Triceratops pony.
Darn it, Larson.
Billies and gentle colts, unfortunately, there's a mighty big storm heading your
way.
Wait,
who's gonna be the fat
idiot?
So we're
gonna have to cut the tour short. Hold on to your flanks.
Hey, everybody! I'm super duper hungry! Is anyone else hungry? I'm gonna go bake some cupcakes!
Oh, Pinkie Pie, no!
Also, I'm running some tests on the computer, so a few things might turn on and off, but don't worry. It's no big deal. You know, computers. Everything's fine! Nothing suspicious going on here!
Oh, come on, not Pinkie Pie. I mean, yeah, granted,
hold on to your flanks.
It's Punko Poe.
10,000 volts of friendship.
Of course.
Wait a minute, Dr. Grant. Maybe he just wants a hug.
No, don't hug it. I can't see if you don't hug it. Its vision is based on friendship.
It's only it makes friendship sound like such a bad thing.
Yeah, but I guess that's the only thing they can really do to make it work. It's an interesting part.
Yeah.
Besides, they already did the vision piece on cuteness.
Shut down the park and stole our dino DNA.
Oh, they did.
Get the power
well,
back
monkey
on.
Movies did.
I told you, Granny. We're completely locked out of the system.
Small mouth.
I'm going with Dr. Ellie's saddle to find the others. Hopefully the Jeep has enough horsepower.
All right. Y'all be careful.
Granny, I can't get Jurassic Park back online without Dennis Pinky.
Hey there, little guy. You're not as big and scary as those other dino ponies. I pinky promise I won't hurt you. Cross my heart and hope to fly, stick a cupcake in my eye.
Well, that's a muffin.
There's muffin to it.
Remind me to thank Granny for this lovely weekend. Dr. Grant and the Phillies are missing. All we could find was Rainbow Malcolm.
Call the mainland. We can't. We lost power to the entire park. Mr. Arnold went to the shed to reset everything.
How long has he been gone?
About 2 hours.
Then something's gone terribly wrong. Ellie, come with me. We're going to turn the power back on. I can see
the
shed from
juice.
Here. We can make it if we trot. No, we can't.
Why not?
Because we're being hunted. Velocirarity. Hiding in the bushes straight ahead.
Holy Celestia.
It's all
this guy
right.
Has not made his touch.
Like
he's lost
it
his
is.
Touch.
Gallop. Towards the shed. I've got her. Go. Now.
Granny, ah. Chicken!
Granny, I think we're back in business! Oh, Mr. Arnold, thank goodness!
No, she made the one in the shed.
Clever
there's still dinosaurs
girl.
In the shed.
Dr. Grant! Ellie! Look out!
I've never seen a dinosaur made to look so cute.
Yay!
Yay!
Spike just ate Rarity. Think about that.
Granny Hammond, after careful
well,
consideration,
he did it,
I've
whatever
decided
he wanted to do.
I ain't gonna endorse your park.
But I'm
yes.
Oh, well. No.
And
you know
go.
What? I was gonna make a joke about Spike and Rarity and eating out, but I couldn't figure out a way to make it.
All right, and now for another one of our favorite animators. This one is for
I'm a Toon Link.
Thank you. Yes, you got it right. But yeah, here we go.
Monday night, and we're coming to you live from the World Herbivore Stadium, and it's time for another round of fighting.
Yay, fighting!
What is it?
This fighting is magic.
Boxing? Wrestling? We can decide, so like, whatever. In this corner, we have our challenger, and his name is John! It's John, it's just John.
Yeah, I'm gonna get ya.
And in this corner,
it's
is
just
the
John.
Champion of champions. He's really strong. Jake? I think it's Jake, I'm not sure.
Hey, bro. You're cruising for a brozen.
All right, shut up. Ready, fight! One knee's down for the count. No, he's back up.
I'm gonna get ya.
You're cruising for a brozen.
Ready, fight! Whoa, that's probably illegal. He's back up.
Come on, man. Let's be civil. How about some chess?
Mets, Hadouken, K.O. Touchdown!
I won, and it was all thanks to my sponsors. Thank you. Thank you.
Alright, Marble Pie meets Fluttershy.
Here.
Wasn't that exciting, ladies and gentlemen? Now, this one, I apologize in advance. This is going to hurt. Apple Bloom's Hula Hoop Song.
How bad could it be?
Sky!
What? Oh, no.
I've got a hula hoop! Sky!
I don't see any hula hoop.
What are you talking about, Sky? It's right here! Hula hoop! Stop judging me! You're horrible!
Welcome to puberty, Apple Bloom.
And there's the original banana song.
Yep.
And now we got.
Seen that. I haven't seen that yet.
Oh, it's good stuff. You'll have to check it out. But for now, Twilight.
Oh, this song.
Imagination here.
Awesome stuff.
I found that way more entertaining than I should have.
The problem is that every time I hear that song, I expect to see a bunny girl riding a missile.
Huh.
I won't ask. Instead, how about this one?
Actually, it's a very famous animation that I just referenced.
Oh, okay. Here's Get Swifty.
Just hit a button, Morty. Give me a beat.
Oh man. Okay.
This
right,
stupid thing.
I was like really soft too.
Oh yeah. You gotta get swifty, you gotta get swifty in here, it's time to get swifty.
Get swifty? What the hell is that?
It's our world's best effort, that's what.
Take off your pants and your panties, shit on the floor, time to get swifty in here, I'm Mr. Bulldog.
Mr. Bulldog?
Don't analyze it, Nathan, it's working.
Hey, take your pants off, it's swifty time today.
So the My Previous Animation thing is pretty good.
Yeah, I like the muffin. It's muffin time, I think it is.
It's muffin time. I play that over and over. It's just too good.
Oh, yeah. Anybody that's been part of the OA stream has definitely known that's since the moment that made itself known to our stream. It has never been the same again.
All right, and now our last video for the night before we close up. Everything Wrong with Sleepless in Ponyville.
3 minutes or less.
I'm never gonna be heard from again! I wanna be heard from!
Lens flare. Recycled scene from season one. Significant changes include Scootaloo's degrading driving skills and Granny's anti-aging witchcraft. Scootaloo attended the Grand Theft Auto School of Avoiding Pedestrians. Scootaloo appears out of thin air and remains motionless for a few frames. Unrealistic airtime cliche. Theme. This game resembles checkers but abides by no rules. Game piece borrowed from a Ouija board. This isn't your average everyday sadness. This is advanced sadness. Applejack performs pre-hike check long after beginning hike. Saddlebags employ TARDIS technology to contain items larger than the bags themselves. Near perfect shot ruined by lone tree. Floating bushes. Minecraft physics.
Do be a sweetheart and see if you can gather some firewood.
Rainbow Dash channels her past self.
Rainbows, darlings, rainbows.
Good job, Applejack. That's enough kindling to last 5 whole seconds.
Best story you ever heard. Is it about the time when Rarity had wings? Maybe it's the second best story you ever heard.
Out of all the amazing adventures Dash has experienced, this remains number one, and some fictional campfire story beats out the rest.
There's no olden pony in our tent.
AJ's masked enthusiasm to be away from her senile grandmother. Scootaloo's front right leg pops off.
Is there a bug in here?
Yes, 4.
I slept like a filly.
Scootaloo is a filly. The word Dash should have used is foal. No pony notices Scootaloo's absence. Before being interrupted by Scoots, Rarity is discussing the use of troughs in public outings. Because what else would a civilized pony like Rarity use? The lack of laws against telekinesis used on others. This cave looks a lot like the cave which the Ursas live in. Scootaloo's wings have vanished, so not too much of a change here, really.
Here you go!
Oh.
That's it?
Scootaloo was merely replicating Applejack's firewood criteria. Leave it to Applejack to heckle during a campfire story. Applebloom and AJ randomly change sleeping bags. Human-sized sleeping bags for ponies which need half the space. That's right, kids. Corks are totally safe things to insert into one's ears. Luna murders a handicapped horse.
Rainbow Dash said it lives here, in these very woods!
So naturally, the only course of action is to leave the safety of friends and go out into the woods alone. Scootaloo has been scootering through the forest, and this didn't happen long ago. This shot's 2007 YouTube resolution. Deus Ex Rainbow Dash. Luna can communicate with ponies looking at the moon. Celestia can do something much similar, but that tends to be problematic. Before revealing, Rainbow Dash always ensures the sky people aren't watching. This is a touching moment, but meanwhile, in another part of the woods, a frantic search for a lost filly is still ongoing. Applejack's shadow is missing, which implies she's the size of a fly and hovering inches from the camera. Every Brony's hopes of seeing Scootaloo actually fly have just been dashed.
Oh!
42 cents.
By the headless horse!
Oh.
42 is the answer to life, the universe, and everything.
I think that pun killed me. I think.
All right, and we got our closing song set up, so that means it's time to close up shop here. We've had fun with a great interview with Everfree Northwest. We examined season 5 and the great finale and got through an entire week worth of Brony content. So I'd say it's time to wrap things up and let things it's time to sleep. It is really time to sleep. So let's get our final shout-outs here. And we're going to start off with our special guest, Bolt the Super Pony.
Oh, thank you. Well, shout-out to you guys for having me on. Thank you so much. It's been an honor. Shout-out to the folks, the nice folks at Everfree Northwest, Ponyville FM, and the Lunacy crew on Celestia Radio. Also, I will just throw it out now, shameless self-advertising. I also have a show on Ponyville FM. It's Saturday. It's technically Saturday at 12 a.m. Eastern time, so Friday nights at 9 p.m. Pacific time, called Music is Timeless, and it's like an hour of really good fandom music. My season 5 special is coming up this Friday, and in February, I'm going to have my first special guest on, probably for the 1-year anniversary, too, if the timing works out right. My special guest is going to be the L-Train, and we're going to premiere Fall of an Empire, the sequel to Moonrise. So yeah, and that's pretty much it, I think. Yeah, and thank you guys so much for having me on. It's been awesome.
Oh, yeah, it's been great having you, too.
Great to come on for the Season 5 premiere and now the Season 5 finale.
Sweet. Well, now we got Season 6 to look forward to.
Woo!
All right, well, let's go on to Suki of the Otaku Ascended.
Yeah, so, what do you think? Well, the only thing that's really different from everything else I've ever said every week is there's no Saturday morning stream this time. And for a while. So,
yeah.
Tomorrow night, if you're into professional wrestling, stuff like that, we record our podcast on Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. over at livestream.com/OAWrestling. Wednesday night, livestream.com/TalkToNoLive has the anime stream. Actually, this week, I believe, should be Slayer's Try and then some Slayer's OVAs. Because we're right at, because we only got 2 episodes left to try. I believe that's all the plan we have right now. Saturday is going to be the OA Let's Play. This week should be me at very least beating Mega Man 5. Hopefully beating both 5 and 6. That's all I got.
Alright, well, let's go on to Deal Grissom.
I never have anything interesting to say for these, so thanks for our guests for coming on, and for all you lovely people for showing up, and hosts, and all that it takes to get the show running. Shouts out to... Hey, Suki, I think you said it's the military bronies? ? I mean, always.
Yeah.
Shout
out to Jared because nobody else will ever do it.
Alright, actually, he shouted himself out, but alright, go for it.
Anywho, I'll catch y'all next time.
Alright, well, let's do our final shout outs then. I'd like to thank you all for joining us for another great episode of the Brony Show. Please be sure to stay tuned because the Open Gore After Party will probably be coming on right after we finish up here. And along with that, Wednesday we got Winchester Wednesday, Saturday we got Creatures Gaming Meltdown, Sundays we also have the Let's Plays with Meet Yours Truly Circuit Main, and we also still have Saturday Morning Cartoons going on. We may not have any new MLP episodes, but it doesn't mean we can't enjoy nostalgic cartoons of the past. To follow all of this, be sure to follow us on our social networks, Twitter, Facebook, Steam, all of them, The Brony Show. You can catch that, all of the links to them over at thebronyshow.net in the bottom right corner. And, that's pretty much it. It's time to wrap it up, call it a night here. So let's do what everybody loves the most, shouting out our wonderful chatters. So, first off, I would like to thank our moderators, CC0Fire, Crazy Mac Captain, for keeping the chat room civil and, well, just civil. Then I'd like to thank Army Dude Elite, Awesome Brony, Blue Quover, Bolt the Super Pony, Bork, Sarcasm, Deal Gris, Dictator Duck, DM12, Dr. Bristle1, Evafan, Fantastic Fred, Imperial Blue, Cold Store, LSKM14, Microchip1, Mike Nice, Prince Spyro, Sand4, Sappy, Sonic5421, Stacy Squid, Applied Relic, Techman, Tokoi, Triskel, Sukiplier, close enough. Supplier, Vaguely Creepy, and yay, Forums. Alright, and of course, another quick shout out to our wonderful, wonderful guest for Everfree Northwest, of course, Bolt the Super Pony, who's here right now still, and also thank you to Tails and Thornwing for letting us have an awesome interview with them and finding out all about Everfree Northwest this year, 5th anniversary. Means, if you can, guys, you gotta find a way to get there, because 5th anniversaries are always epic. And to shout us all out, here's a classic PMV that I enjoyed several years early in the community, and might as well enjoy it now. Phenomenon! Because how we're doing this show after over 20 episodes is definitely a phenomenon. And have a good night, everybody!
On your nitrous and let's go. Destination for now. navigation. Man up your stations, feel the sensation. Surround invasion with communication. Move quick, we might avoid contamination. Down, it comes to sound. Everyone down, your feet to this phenomenon. Now, let's make it loud and show them all how you move to this phenomenon. Roll, open your soul, maybe lose control inside of this phenomenon. Just let yourself go and let everyone know you move to this. Crawl up beside us, they want to bite us, inject the virus. Raise up your lighters, raise to the righteous, need you to guide us. Get prepared to go, if you like us, calling our riders. Crawl up beside us, no place to hide us. All freedom fighters, let's unite us, switch on, unite us, and let's go. Down, it comes to sound, everyone down, your feet to this phenomenon. Now, let's make it loud. Show them all how you move to this phenomenon. Roll, open your soul, maybe lose control inside of this phenomenon. Just let yourself go and let everyone know you move to this phenomenon. Can't take it anymore, shake it till we move the floor. What are we waiting for? Let's go. Tired of being ordinary, don't care if there's people staring. Rely on your strength to carry me on. I'm not invisible like you. To this phenomenon now, let's make it loud and let's show them all how you move to this phenomenon. Roll open your soul, maybe lose control inside of this phenomenon. Just let yourself go and let everyone know you move to this phenomenon. You move to this phenomenon.
The phenomenon is that I can stay awake and still work 5 hours from now.
Yeah.